Hi everyone, welcome to Python learning series 102 continues. In this series, we will see how to initiate SSH connection from a jump host using Python. Here in this script, you can see I am using a jump host with IP 0.18 and I am using Netmiko, and the device type is Linux SSH, and from that machine I'm initiating SSH connection using redispatch method in Netmiko. And here you can see the device type is changing to Cisco IOS. And from there I'm executing certain commands. You can see the commands here: show IP interface brief, IP route, and printing those outputs and handling some exceptions. Let me just try running this script and show you. So now it is trying to connect to the jump host, which is 0.18 in our case, and it is printing the prompt of that jump host and trying to connect to the destination router using this command, and it is waiting for the password prompt and it is entering the password. And here you can see it is printing the destination device prompt. Can see the device IP 0.50 and host name was CSR_50, and I'm executing all these commands: show IP interface brief, show IP route, and here show users. In show users, you can see the connected IP is 0.18. if you want to verify this device IP, it is 0.14. so the device with 0.18 is Ubuntu secondary. So you can see the IP address here, its IP is 0.18. now let me go back to Ubuntu primary. So here I have one more script. In that script I am using a Cisco device itself as a jump host. You can see another device IP is 0.49, and from there I am connecting to 0.50, and executing some commands. Let me just try running this script. So you can see here, it is connecting to CSR49, and then from there it is executing this command. So you can see the command is different for Cisco and Linux for initiating SSH to another host. So here we are giving SSH-L and username. In Linux we were giving SSH space username at IP address, and after that we are waiting for the prompt, password prompt. We are entering the password, then we got connected to 50, and you can see here the user details. I'll be explaining these script logics in detail. So before we move into the script, let's see how to restrict SSH access to only those two machines. Now from this machine I should be able to SSH to 0.50. let us try that. It is prompting for password, but let me try restricting that. So I'll go to the secondary machine, and from there I'll create an access list. I'll just create a standard access list, and I'll give permit and 192.168.0.18 permit. I'll give host and then I'll give the IP. 18 is the secondary Ubuntu machine and 49 is another CSR router. I'll give access to these two machines. Now let me go to primary machine and try initiating SSH. Yeah, I need to apply this ACL to the line VTY. Let me apply that. Line VTY 04 access class 1. You need to give in. Let me save the config. Go to primary. We'll try initiating the connection. You can see here now connection is getting refused from 0.14. Now let me try initiating it from secondary. So from this machine still I'll be able to access. And here one more thing what you need to notice is when I execute this, so I'm directly getting the prompt for password. Even the script logic will be expecting this prompt. So let us have a look into the script. You can see here it will be expecting the password prompt in the output. But if you don't have that SSH key added as trusted, we'll be getting another message. I'll show that here. So you need to add any host as a trusted host in the jump host before you initiate SSH connection. For example, here if you want to see the trusted host, home folder /.ssh, then here you can see known host list. And if I remove all these keys, and if I initiate a connection here, now I'll be getting this prompt. During the execution of script, if you get this prompt, it won't work because script will be expecting a password prompt. So for that, you need to add that host as trusted first, then you need to run it from the script. Now if you verify it again, you can see this has been added as trusted here. I have created another video explaining all this and using SSH key. You can have a look into that. And here in the script, I have covered some basic exceptions like jump host authentication failed, jump host not reachable, and unable to connect to any device. Here, jump host, if I give different IP, let us try running it. You can see here, we are getting the message jump host not reachable. And if I give a wrong password, you can see here I'm getting the message jump host authentication failed. And for router IP, if I give different IP, we'll get a message unable to get output from any device. So in the next video, I'll be explaining all this logic in detail. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.